So this would be a very simple model, because I'm going to do it in just a couple of minutes here. So we're going to assume you're a college student who manages to be absolutely penniless, which is most college students I've ever encountered. That's a fairly good assumption. And you know, you're graduating from college and you've been listening to old Professor O'Brien and realize I'm really supposed to be putting aside some money for my old age. So you start off with nothing. So I'm going to put in equals, and then I'm going to put in the cell reference of H2, because that's where my initial amount was. And it says, okay, fine, that's a zero, I understand that. Then, just to simplify this, I'm not going to do any compounding. I'll just say at the end of the year, whatever you get a 5% interest payment. That just simplifies the calculation. So, that equals B2 times H4. Now, since you had no money in there, you didn't get any interest this year. But because you listened to your old professor, at the end of the year, December 31st, you stick $1,000 into your account. Which means at the end of the year, you have whatever you had at the beginning of the year. But I didn't put in equals to that. So I end the year with $1,000. So what do I begin the following year with?
Ending amount of the previous year?
Yeah.
The contents of
V2. Right. So now I can just fill now. Initially you're not going to see anything. Why? Because when I go here, it's now pointing to E3, which has nothing in it, and now it's pointing to E4. So in other words, until you do all of these, you're not going to get anywhere. Neat little trick. I can select all three of these. Instead of doing it one at a time, okay, now what went wrong? So I click on this, B3, that's what I want, H5, well H5 is down here. That's not right. Well, this is where we make use of the distinction between absolute and relative cell references. All right? I have a cell that reference that I do not wish to change. When I click and drag, normally the default is increment your cell references by one. I don't want that to happen this time. So what I will do is I will come in here. Now, you can do these independently. But I'm just going to do both of them, no harm. Use the dollar sign. The dollar sign says this is an absolute reference, do not change no matter what clicking and dragging this idiot does. Keep it to that cell reference. Now here what happened was something kind of similar. It was picking that up and adding an 05 onto it, so I don't want that. So what I want to do is I want to come back in and say on this one, that was an absolute H3. So I don't want either of those to change. So now I've got that, an absolute reference to I wanted H4 on that one, didn't I? Fix those. Now I'm just fill these again. There. That looks a lot better. So I now have something that is going to tell me, based on a very, very simplistic model. You know, I've got some sort of investment account that gives me 5% a year. I add $1,000 a year. What do I have at the end of 40 years? I come down, take a look, and say, well, $127,000. All right, now, that's not bad. I can do stuff with this. And so typically, what I would do is point out that, you know, if you decide to wait 10 years to get started, what you have to do is go to the bottom of this list and go back 10 to find out what you wind up with. You know, it's the when you wait 10 years, you lose the biggest 10. And when I was teaching economics, that was a useful lesson. But what I want to do is explain what-if analysis and why all of this matters. I can just copy this entire sheet. And to do that, I just hold down the Control key, click on the sheet name, and pull it over, and I get sheet 2.2. 2_2, actually. So I want to go back and make sure I understand what all of these things mean. So if I right-click on the sheet name, I can rename. So I'll just call that the base. And I'll right-click on that and rename it. So let's call this the more saving model. Now all I have to do at this point, just make one change. So I'm going to say, what happens if I save 2,000 a year instead of 1,000? With that one change, because I constructed the model the right way, the entire thing recalculates. And I think if you go back and compare them, if you save twice as much, you wind up with twice as much. Right. So, not exactly rocket science here yet, but let's keep going. I can do another one. So, instead of changing the amount I save, let's change the interest rate. And that almost quadruples the amount of money instead of doubling. So when I was teaching my students, it was, the moral of the story was, you can save smart or you can save hard. And save hard is just trying to pile up money in a low interest account. Saving smart is find a way to get a high rate of return. But what we're trying to establish here is If you build the model the right way, the what-if analysis becomes so simple. And this is why, you know, I could go through, I click on any of these cells, all I'm ever gonna see is cell references of some kind. So that's why I would say to my students, I'm gonna start clicking on all the cells and see what you got in there. If it's just a number, you lose a point. Because I can't do this unless I build the model the right way. So, we've seen how we can do that using cell references. I've showed you, you know, how to copy a sheet, make additional copies, how to rename it. Now, other things you can do. This was a case where, all right, let's see if I can.
Quicken has all the formulas all set up for the financial. That's what Quicken is using, the spreadsheet, but they already got all the formulas set up, right?
Yeah. They have a lot of it.
I think Quicken's more of a database model than a spreadsheet model.
TurboTax.
That's definitely database.
A database, and that's got the what's the abbreviation? OD what?
ODB, I think.
ODD?
B. Base.
Base. Yeah. Do they TeamViewer? Do they have one for Linux too? Anybody know?
I think they do have a TeamViewer for Linux. They don't have login for Linux.
So if one person's got Windows TeamViewer, another person has Linux TeamViewer.
I'm pretty sure.
Okay, so I don't recognize TeamViewer. What is?
You haven't heard of TeamViewer?
No.
Application. That's strange because I've heard of it and it's only related to Ford's, our guys getting into Ford databases. To see the drawings for the parts. But I heard it's getting phased out, so.
TeamViewer?
For Fords. They went to something else.
There's a lot of them. Looking at PNC, that's up there.
Yeah.
There's quite a few of them. TeamViewer, RDP, desktop technology.
So do we have any questions for Kevin and his calc? I mean, I could keep him all here all day talking about calc and various questions I have about it. So we're kind of comfortable with the basics that he's provided. And all right, thank you.
Well, you'll find a lot more if you go to my website.
And what was your website?
AHUKA.com.
Okay, great. Thank you very much.
The first screen you started off with had those.
Yeah. Okay, great. Thank you.